Hello everyone, we are from Group 9. In this video, we are going to present our computer science project, which is about the impact of COVID-19 on the world. In this project, we aim to investigate the factors that influence COVID-19 infection and the prediction of a new case in the future. From our world in data, a COVID-19 dataset given by instructor assigned in the term of a class project. Firstly, let me meet the team member. We have Sarita Interracial, Thanapon Khunphom, and Sarat Mungthongsam. For the content outline, it includes Milestone 1, Milestone 2, and the summary. For the first milestone, there are data exploration, data preparation, and visualization of the COVID-19 dataset. In data exploration, we start by looking around the dataset. The dataset contains the data on each day for each country from 2019 until the beginning of this year. The main data type is an object and float number, and the data column represents the set of information. In data preparation, we would like to explain the detail and problem that we found on the data set. And according to our scope, which is the Asia continent, we only select the row that have a value Asia on the continent column. We change the type of variable date from object to date and time. We check the number of null value for each column and refine the column that contain null value and deface them. And we only check the number of null value again. The next is data visualization. This was created by using matplotlibrary, seaborn, and plotlibrary. We decided to focus on a new case for plotting the graph to support our finding. We plot the line graph to see the relationship in each month to compare the value in each month. As can be seen in the left-hand side graph, the relationship between vaccinated in each month in the year 2021 found that the number in each country increased from July to October and drop down after November. On the right-hand side, there are relationship between the high value of death in August because this year early state of vaccination for people. However, a month after people got vaccinated, the number of death cases is decreasing. Next is the relationship between stringency in each country. It shows that countries with the most stringency epidemic measure are countries that with a high stringency index. So at this point, the country with a high stringency index, such as Thailand, Myanmar, and Malaysia, there are the new cases that have decreased.
The second milestone is to build machine learning models from COVID-19 dataset that are quite useful and practical. Once we have the models, they have to perform a proper model evaluation to show that our model generalizes well to unseen data, and we would like to explain the techniques that we use for model training and model evaluation. Our goal is to predict the possibility of new cases according to the multiple variables, which are total cases, total deaths, people fully vaccinated, stringency index, and population density. And next is a machine learning model that we implemented for our project. There are three models used here, which is multiple linear regression, support vector machine, and short-term memory. Multiple linear regression is best suited when a continuous dependent variable is hard to predict from several independent variables. Therefore, this model is one of our choice that can support our machine learning. The second one is support vector machine. This model can support both classification and regression problems. So we think that our dataset can be suited to this model. We will use support vector regression to be our second model. And the last one is long short-term memory, or LSTM. It's a type of recurrent neural network that can learn long-term dependencies between time steps of sequence data. And we use this model because it supports our data set in terms of the time series forecasting to predict new cases for each day. For example, an LSTM model that makes a prediction 1 hour into the future, given 6 hours of history, would need a window like this. And the next part is the techniques for model prediction. For first two models, which are multiple linear regression and support vector regression, they have a similar process, but we will replace the date column with a new column that represents the date in integer numbers. The first step is divide the data into X for features and Y for labels, and split data into training, validation, and tests. Instead of splitting the data randomly, we change to split data in sequential order because our data is related to time series. And number three is import the model and fit the training set into the model. Number four, predict the new cases in training, validation, and tests.And predict the new case in test set and evaluate the performance of our training, validation, and test set. And for long short-term memory model, it has little different process. Separate this for future plotting and specify the data for prediction on this machine learning model. And the data that is extracted from future country will have no date. And normalize the features using standard scalar and split data into the training set, define the model, and fit the data set into the model, and find the range of the data set for prediction, predict the selected range of the data set, and rescale the data set back to the original.
And in this slide, here are the results of train test set evaluation that we try to evaluate in multiple linear regression. As can be seen, the performance of this model is notas good as we expect. When we see the value of mean square error, we think that there are the other models that can work for time series data with better performance. And here are the results of the train test evaluation that we try to evaluate in this model. The mean standard error of mean square error of the test set is quite bad, and the value of each data in the test set too similar. We assume that the data set that we use for machine learning might be too big, so the performance of this model might not be efficient enough. And here are the result of train test set evaluation that we try to evaluate in this model. This model had the lowest mean square error compared to the first two models. Also, the training and test set have the slope line. That kind of makes sense when we see the actual new case. And in the summary, the data preparation, we filter only Thailand, Malaysia, Cambodia, Laos, and Myanmar, and then transform the date column to the date time format, filling now value bar both manual and filled with the course. And to predict the new cases of its country, that is our goal. For the model selection, we use multiple linear regression, support vector machine, long short-term models. And in the model evaluation, we use two main metrics for model evaluation, mean square error and R-square. Estimate value of test set of each model can be seen in this slide. And for the best model, according to the model evaluation, long short-term model is the best model for predicting new case. And for why we want to predict new case, because we want to estimate how much of each country should prepare for COVID policy in the future. And after seeking the data visualization, we found that increasing the number of vaccination can decrease the number of deaths, because we found that Thailand has a low death compared to the other four countries, which are Myanmar, Cambodia, Laos, and Malaysia, due to the high vaccination rate, because vaccine can prevent people from getting COVID-19. Moreover, we will find other models that can improve the performance of the new COVID-19 case prediction. And that's all for our presentation. Thank you for your attention.